well, plans have changed, so I'm not going to be living with my dad. And I asked the guy, I said, well, where am I going? He goes, well, you're going to go to where you're going to be living. I said, well, where's that? He said, well, Bruno. I was like, Bruno? And then when I started my wrestling career, I didn't start in the big bright lights of WWE. I started down in Memphis in that territory. And again, I had no place to live. And he brought me in, and I stayed with him in his trailer.
Yeah, Lakeview Trailer Park.
In Walls, Mississippi. Yeah. And then here we are, we're on the set of Young Rock, which is a story about my life. And Bruno is such a big part of that. I bought my first car from a crackhead.
Yeah.
And what did he say? He said, who wants to buy this?
Who wants to buy this Thunderbird? I got a Thunderbird for sale. He goes, man, Bruno, can we get it? Can we get it? The guy goes, I want 80 bucks for it.
Yeah.
I said, I'll give you 40. We'll come back tomorrow. I'll give you the other 40. No, and we'd never see him again. We took the car. I trailed him back to the Alamo Plaza. There was no license tag on the car. Nothing.
No.
The windshield was broke out. And we were driving. Well, he was driving. He pulled over. And I said, uh-oh, it done gave out already?
Yeah.
No. Another crackhead popped up from behind the seat under the blankets.
Oh,
dude, where are we going? And Dewey said, man, you got to get out. I just bought this car from your friend. Oh, sorry, man. Let me get my stuff. Off he went.
Get out. Do we get the crackhead out of the car? I can't thank you enough for when I was 15 and you had every right to say, I don't know this kid. I don't want him to live with me. And you took me in. And truly, Bruno, it means so much to me that you did that, because it actually helped change the course of my life. And I love you and I appreciate it. And I thank you for buying me my first car from that crackhead. And now I have an opportunity now to tell you, this is your new car.
Oh my God. Oh my God. I want to hug you so bad, but COVID won't let
me. Put your mask up. All right, come here.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Come on, check out your new car.
What do I do? Just drive it home and get tags?
No. I got the tags ready for you, and I'm going to have it shipped to your trailer.
Oh my God.
In Walls.
Oh my God. Are you serious?
I'm serious, brother. What do you think?
I mean, nobody's ever done me like this before. I can't believe it. I love you so much. Before this, without this, with nothing.
I love you too, man. I just want to show my appreciation to you, Bruno.
Oh my God.
It's a little thing, but I want you to take this back to Walls, Mississippi, where I have stayed before, in Walls, Mississippi, in Bruno's trailer. And I always appreciate it.
I'll never forget. Oh my God. What is this, a Ford?
F-150.
Oh my God. I love you, man. Not because it is, because of who you are. I can't believe it. Thank you, man. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for putting you in my life. Like I told you earlier, there's only about 5 people in the world I would die for, and you're one of them.
Well, I don't want you to die, Bruno. Come on.
Thank you, man. Oh, my God.
You're welcome.
Oh, my God.
You look good in this in Walls, wouldn't you?
My God,
there's no crackheads in there either.
Are you sure?
There's no crackheads in this car.
Thank you, man.
Oh, you're welcome, Bruno. Just wanted to do something for you. I thought it might be cool, you know, since we got our first car together. Felt like such a cool full circle thing, right? We're here on the set of Young Rock. It's about my teenage years and all the crazy shit that you and I did together. And you got me my first car from that crackhead for 40 bucks. By the way, there's a crackhead out there who...
Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's Zen. We are back here with another video. Now, this one's going to be rather long, and I'm actually happy about that because I'm about to tell you guys a story of how I made my lifelong friends and how these friends are still sticking with me to this very day, even recent ones. All right, so first, I'm going to start off with my friends that I grew up with in high school. Now, these dude bros, these homies, my friends Maurice, my friend Dre, my friend Thomas, my friend Aaron, we stuck together like glue. You know, even when we were as kids, we were a bunch of knuckleheads, but we still stuck together like glue. You know, Dre came in 7th grade, and I think Maurice came in 6th grade. But me, Thomas, and Aaron have been close friends since we were kids. Now, at first, wasn't really fond of Aaron at all. Like, wasn't really fond of him at all, because he was an annoying kid. Wasn't a bad kid, but was just annoying. You know what I'm saying? You know, you have that one kid that's always annoying. But one thing I will say is he was loyal, though. Even now, Aaron is still one of the most loyal friends I have. But now, back to what I was saying. As we grew up, you know, we went through many different trials and tribulations together. You know, we would be pranking each other, calling each other about, like, first it was simple kid shit. You know, we were calling each other about, oh, you seen the new Yu-Gi-Oh! GX show that just came on? We'll have discussions about it. This is how the friendship started. We'll start calling each other, you know, before, you know, cell phones were really big. Yeah, I'm old. Before cell phones were really big back then, we would call each other, have discussions about, oh, Yu-Gi-Oh! GX or the newest show that came out on Toonami. And we'll have our conversations about that. See, when I would come home from school, this one, my mom was still would be working in Jersey. So therefore, after I would finish my homework, I would usually call my friend Thomas, who usually call me, and we'll be talking about stuff like that. You know, we were always talking about shows and everything like that, what was going on during the day and how it affected us. You know, that's how us kids talked back then. It was simple, it was silly, it was harmless. But as we got older and cell phones were introduced and everything, this is where it changed. Because now, as we got cell phones, as we got cell phones and such, Aaron will be calling me, or I'll call him more. We'll just be disgusting nonsense. Let me just tell y'all something about Aaron real quick. My dude's a fucking knucklehead. He's like the one of the most hilarious people you'll ever meet or come across a day in your life. When I say this dude is hilarious, he's hilarious. Like, for real. He's funny. But I will say this, one of the things that made me really grow close to Aaron was one day was, I'm not going to go into crazy amounts of detail, but he was in a relationship. It ended, and we was all in class one day. Now, one thing you got to know about Aaron is, once he's in something, he's in it 100%. That goes for anything in life, anything he does. Once he's in it, he's committed 100%. So it didn't turn out too well. My boy broke down in class. What really transcended our friendship was when everybody, including myself, we all stopped working just to comfort your boy. You know what I'm saying? Like, we literally stopped and we helped him out. We pulled him out of that situation. Kept checking up on him, kept talking to him, and everything like that. You know? Like, that's what transcended the friendship between Aaron and myself. You know, of course, we still had a little spats back then and there, but I mean, that's what brothers do. But at the end of the day, that's what transcended our friendship with Aaron, with me and Aaron. Now, with Dre, he came in 7th grade. Let me tell you about Dre. Dre's one of the calmest dudes you'll ever meet. Like, this dude never gets mad at anything. Giant-ass teddy bear. Like, you legitimately have to try your hardest to piss him off. For real. One thing that I will say about Dre is, though, like, this is what made him one of my brothers is, during high school, it was a chick that I was dealing with at the time. Not going to expose her name or whatever, but it was just back and forth games during my Simpy Wimpy days. You understand? It was stuff like that. And even though I didn't know what to do at the time, Dre, I always vented to Dre. Never judged, never looked down, anything. He always gave advice, because, you know, Dre's always older than me. So he gave advice on how to handle certain things, you know? It's one thing I can say I love about Dre. Like, that's one of the qualities he has. He never judged, never looked down. He always gave advice, and he's always there to make you laugh. One thing Dre will do is he'll make you laugh while giving you advice. It's one of the greatest qualities he has. That's why he's still my brother till this very day. Okay, like that's my dude right there. And one thing about Dre is, This dude always, yo, his laugh is infectious. Like, if he's laughing, you gonna be laughing too. Now, back to what I was saying. He never judged and he never looked down. He always made sure anything he asked of you, he always made sure to give it back to you. Like, that was one of the rules of our, you know, little school family. You know, if one person had it and somebody else needed it, they always had it, you know? Like, this is the same thing, you know, for example, like, because I used to work in a coffee shop at school, you know? Every Friday, they would be making bacon, egg, and cheese. And one of the things that I would not do is every time I got paid, it wasn't much, like, anytime I got paid is if one of my homies came in and they was hungry, I'll make sure they have something to eat. You know, like, Dre came in, was like, yo, I didn't have no breakfast this morning. I was just rushing out. I was like, yo, bro, don't worry about it. I got you. Here, just take this bacon, egg, and cheese. Bro, I'll pay you back for it. Nah, don't worry about it. It's always been like that. It's been like that with Dre, Thomas, Aaron, Maurice, anybody who needed it. You know, like, that's one of the things that I've always done because that was something that my mom's taught me. But back to Dre. He'll always look out. And he'll always look out despite the situation. Dre's one of the people who always look out. If he can't make it, it's a legitimate reason why he can't. And if he can, he's fully supporting you, you know? Like, that's why Dre is one of my lifelong friends. Now, me and Tom is something different. We're thick as thieves. Like, that's my homie right there. Now, as we was growing up, Thomas, I can honestly say, was admittedly more popular than I was. As we were going into our middle school years. So yeah, it was much more different, like all the cute girls after him. But one thing that me and Thomas did is he was always like, that was my nigga. Like, every time he needed something, or anytime he would ask for something or he'll need somebody to talk to, was always there. Now, there was this one event that changed our friendship. It transcended it for the better. Let me tell you what that event was. So I used to always stay up late and play God of War 3. That was my thing. I was completing, like, for PlayStation 3, I had the God of War trilogy. So I was trophy hunting, so I was trying to get every trophy for all the God of Wars. So I was playing God of War 3 one night, and it was 2:37 in the morning. So I got a call from him. And again, this was a situation he was dealing with, and he called me. I picked up. We talked for like 3 hours. From 2:37 to 5:49, we was on the phone because he was just venting. I was just giving him advice on how to handle something. That was the situation. That was the one event that transcended our friendship. That was the one where we became brothers for life. We was already close, but this one made us even closer. You understand what I'm saying? And yeah, there's more people that's gonna be on this. There's more people that's gonna be on here. So don't worry. It's not just dumb. It's not just the people that I just mentioned at the first part. Now, my friend Maurice was something different. Me and Mo, we were kind of similar. We had similar traits. We had similar interests. We had similar, you know, hobbies and such. We was cool people. You know what I'm saying? Mo was that dude. You know, he was kind of like the black goth kid if it was cool. You feel what I'm saying? But he was always down for anything. Now, that's one thing I can say about Mo. He'll make sure you straight before he's straight. Like, that was one thing that Mo always did. Can't even, like, deny that. Mo was my nigga. But now back to what I was saying. Mo would always, you know, look out for other people more than he did himself. And we had to, like, reel him in sometimes because he was the type of dude to where he'll go to war for somebody who wouldn't dare go to war for him, you know? Like, that's something that Mo did. That was something that Mo always done. Now, we went to this. Now, myself, Dre, Thomas, Maurice went to this program called Visions. This is something that we usually did every single year. And we went for like the 4 days out of the week in February. Now, this is where I met my other lifelong friend. His name is Justin. Now, Justin is my homie. He's actually one of the people who helped inspire me to create this YouTube channel because I started seeing his. I'll link his channel in the description below. So anybody who I mentioned that has a YouTube channel, I'll link their channels in the description so you know who I'm talking about. All right? So that was my dude. Always, Justin was the epitome of selfless. Like, always the epitome of selfless. Always gave encouragement, gave whatever he had, anything. You needed something, if he had it, you got it. You know, like, that's who Justin was. That's who Justin is, I'm sorry. That's who he is. As a matter of fact, he's one of the channels that I watch daily, because if you knew his story, his shit is inspiration. I'm gonna be straight up. Like, I can't tell you his situation, but I'll let him tell you. And if you don't believe me, you can listen to his story on Spotify via the Gritty Knows Best podcast. You know, hit that up. You'll like it. You really will. You can also see him on his own YouTube channel and on the Gritty World YouTube channel. Look those up. Now, back to the lifelong friends. There was a recent lifelong friend that I met through that I met on Donovan Sharp's stream. And one of his is, I don't know if you guys know him, that's Red Sings the Blues. Like, I will link his channel in the damn description, and I want you guys to go check that out. Alright, like, turns out, dude's a year younger than me. Dude is also, from the same borough as I, and from the same city as I am, both from New York. And it's cool as fuck. Like, we discuss all this YouTube shit. He calls me whenever he needs advice, or whenever he's going through something. Like, that's one of my homies. Like, Red Sings the Blues is one of my homies. And the best part about it is, we don't judge each other on anything. That's what I can say about all my friends. We don't judge each other on anything. This is why you need lifelong friends. You need to grow bonds. You need to connect. You need to establish bridges with other people. Shit is vital, because if you try to sit there and go it alone, those problems that you may have or dark places, you won't be able to get out of them without those friendships. And the reason why I say that is because some of these people have gotten me out of dark places. Like, when my grandmother died, it was my friends who came in and helped me get out of that dark place. When my dogs died, it was my friends who did the exact same thing. You understand? So I say that all to say, fellas, like, if you got some lifelong dude bro friends, let them know. Like, yo, bro, like, I appreciate the fact that you've been brothers for so long. So that's the kind of video I wanted to make today. You know what? I will say this. I'll be making more videos. I'm going to just be straight up. I've been bullshitting, and I've been trying to get some house shit done. But I will make more videos. Please like, comment, share, subscribe. And I'll see you all in the next one. And you have a wonderful day.